The answer in the great majority of cases is that it does not weaken the heart in any way. So for the great majority of young people that we get that require an ablation, that will be either because they've got SVT, an arrhythmia coming from the top chambers of the heart, or an accessory pathway such as Wolff, Parkinson, White's. The amount of tissue that you damage within your heart is really minuscule to treat both those conditions, so the heart is usually not affected. For other conditions such as cardiomyopathy, such as hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, arrhythmogenic cardiomyopathy, or individuals who have a very high burden of extra pathways coming from the bottom chambers, then you may require more extensive ablation in order to silence those heart cells that are causing the extra beats. Those are more complicated cases, and in those cases the ablation may destroy a more significant amount of their heart tissue, but again that amount of tissue compared to the total heart tissue will be a relatively low amount.